Hello viewers, today we shall discuss the rare complication of scleral necrosis that follows ocular surgical procedures. The most common surgery associated with scleral necrosis is pterygium excision followed by cataract surgery, but it has been described with others as well. Rheumatoid arthritis and granulomatosis with polyangiitis or Wegener's granulomatosis are the most common predisposing factors for developing postoperative scleral necrosis, the others being these. In many instances, surgically induced scleral necrosis represents the initial manifestation of occult systemic disease. For this reason, a complete preoperative medical history and physical examination are necessary to detect patients at risk for scleral necrosis. Coming to pathogenesis, trauma, infections, ischemia, toxicity, and autoimmunity are some of the mechanisms by which surgically induced scleral necrosis develops. Ocular trauma, whether accidental or surgical, is a triggering factor that can cause scleral necrosis via different pathogenic mechanisms involving anomalous local and systemic immunologic factors. All of them have delayed wound healing in common. Ocular wound healing requires collagen synthesis and tissue neovascularization, which may be hampered by the collagenolytic activity of post-op corticosteroids, the use of which must therefore be judicious in high-risk patients. Various microorganisms produce infectious surgically induced scleral necrosis, with bacteria being more common than fungi. Pseudomonas aeruginosa is the most common bacterium implicated, and among the fungi are the Pseudosporium species followed by Aspergillus species. Ischemia and delayed wound healing predispose to post-op infectious scleritis, which may then result in scleral necrosis. The scleral stroma is mainly avascular and meets its metabolic demands through choroidal blood vessels and the episcleral vascular network. Mechanical compression from scleral buccal surgery and excessive cautery could produce localized ischemia, representing a risk factor for postoperative scleral necrosis. However, because of the low metabolic demands of a healthy sclera, ischemia is rarely the sole cause for scleral necrosis and is often aided by delayed wound healing and necrosis of tissue, as in with excessive cauterization. Radiation-induced scleral necrosis occurs usually months to years after brachytherapy. However, indirect triggering pathogenic mechanisms including local ischemic inflammation from extraocular muscle manipulation, tumor necrosis, and occult autoimmune disease may accelerate the appearance of scleral necrosis to within a few weeks. Mitomycin C through avascularity and scleral thinning and 5-FU through delayed wound healing can also predispose to scleral necrosis. Scleral necrosis associated with autoimmune disease is related to a delayed type 3 hypersensitivity reaction, wherein exposed tissue autoantigens result in immune complex deposition around episcleral vessel walls. This results in activation of the classic complement pathway, ultimately resulting in cellular damage by lysosomal enzymes. Furthermore, patients with rheumatic diseases tend to exhibit eye conditions related to poor wound healing, such as keratoconjunctivitis sicca, rosacea, atopic keratoconjunctivitis, meibomian gland dysfunction, chronic blepharitis. These are all associated with surface inflammation and dry eye, predisposing to poor wound healing and collagen lysis. In the early stages of the disease, patients may complain of conjunctival hyperemia and mild pain, symptoms that are usually attributed to dry eye disease or conjunctivitis, thus delaying the diagnosis and treatment. Moderate cases present with the typical porcelain white necrotic sclera with or without perforation and uveal prolapse. In advanced surgically induced necrosis, the patients usually present with moderate to severe pain and other features of scleral thinning and necrosis. Even though scleral necrosis may be associated with infection, it must be differentiated from post-op infectious scleritis, which is usually associated with the presence of a purulent discharge or subconjunctival abscess. The location of the scleral necrosis depends on the type of surgical procedure performed. Typically, post-pterygium scleral necrosis occurs in the interpalpebral area adjacent to the limbus. Cyclodestructive procedures also result in perizymbal necrosis, but this is mainly in the superior or inferior quadrants. Perizymbal superonasal necrosis is seen following cataract surgery in patients with autoimmune disease. More posterior scleral necrotic lesions are seen after filtering valve implantation and after scleral buckling surgery. A complete workup to detect autoimmune diseases must be performed. Smears and culture sensitivity is mandatory to rule out scleral necrosis with superinfection or an infectious scleritis. The pathology is basically one of vasculitis along with a granulomatous inflammation. Treatment widely varies depending on the presentation, associated factors and severity. In infectious scleral necrosis, broad spectrum topical and systemic antibiotics and antifungals are indicated as initial management pending swab and culture reports. Oral prednisone with or without adjunctive oral NSAIDs is the drug of choice for non-infectious scleral necrosis. Duration and tapering will depend, of course, on the response. Intravenous methylprednisolone for 3 days is useful in patients with severe and rapidly progressive inflammation as well as in oral intolerance. Immunosuppressive drugs are used in non-responsive or severe cases to supplement or to reduce the requirement of systemic steroids. Some drugs used for necrotizing scleritis include methotrexate, azathioprine, mycophenolate mofetil, cyclosporin A, tacrolimus and cyclophosphamide. Biologic immunomodulatory agents such as tumor necrosis factor inhibitors like infliximab, adalimumab, rituximab, in addition to some of the newer ones, and anakinra, an interleukin-1 receptor antagonist, have also been successfully employed for refractory cases. Surgical management is required in cases that do not respond to medical management and may be in the form of conjunctival resection in selected cases of rapidly progressive necrosis to decrease collagenase and pro-inflammatory cytokines and tectonic grafts in areas of extreme scleral degradation. Of those that may be used, preserved sclera is the most commonly used material. So that's it for today. If you like what you saw, subscribe to my channel and hit the bell icon to never miss an update from AP's Ophthalmology Pulse. You may watch my other videos by clicking on the thumbnails. Please leave a note in the comment section if you wish for any particular topic to be covered in future. Look forward to regular updates. Thank you for watching.